Okay, let's make a start. Number one, tricky one to start with. Remove dipstick. What's number two? The breather extension. Something to do with that, is it? Let's have a look under here. I've had a bit of trouble with my videos lately, that there's been radio in the background and YouTube have pulled it. Okay. I'm not sure that had to come off, but it's off now. Right, next. Dynamo. Okay, that seems to be a 21 millimeter. I'll probably replace this with an alternator anyway. That's quite nice, it's a fixed nut there. I like that idea. So this is the next bit in the book. Fuel pump to carburetor. And this little nut on this little bolt here, I don't know if that's a rogue bolt, but I can't find a spanner that'll fit that. It's 13.5 millimeters or something. Okay, rocker cover now. And I see why you had to take this off, because the nut's there for the third nut. I think this is a 7 mil. Well, that one is. I'm going to try and leave it like that. I don't want those nuts dropping into there, and they're brass. You can't put a magnet on them. I don't know if I can get a spanner on that.
tight.
Well, that's not bad. Let's have a closer look. You could say there's a tiny amount of rust there, but nothing bad. I wonder if I should just turn the engine over, just see if that
feels up and down. Just that one there that's down, we'll just try that. Yeah, that's coming up, so I'm happy with that. Right, what's next?
Spark plugs and wires. Well, I've already done the wires. Not right, but they're not bad. A bit sooty, a bit oily, but well, whatever. Petrol pump.
These bolts are long enough. Thank you. Right, water pump. This is the, I'm sort of concerned about this one. It had got water in it. And it doesn't look that healthy. And of course, these are all stuck. And they're only tiny. I really don't want to break anything off here. That one's loose. Yeah, you can't get a spanner on anything here. Might get a socket on that. No. Oh, these are tight. I've got a weird one there. Hey, you got a loose one. I'm going to have to put a bit of heat on those. Right, what's going to be the least damage? Propane or oxyacetylene? And what I'm going to do, I'm going to give them a quick blast with this and then cool them immediately. Right, so I'm not going to do that because I'm out of gas, I'm out of oxygen. It's going to have to be propane. I think that'll be all right. Right, see if that's done anything. No, I'm not happy with that one. That one's all right. That one's all right. I think that one's all right. Going to take this off next. It's in the way. Seventeen millimeter.
That's better. I can get to everything now. That was okay. That one's tight. Okay. Okay. That's a tight one still. That's that one, and which one was it? Oops. That was opposite two. Warm them up again. I think that's loose now. Oh, the looser it's going to break. That's it, I think we're all free now. Put a bucket under there. Of course, by the time I found a bucket, it stopped running.
That's different, that one. Ten or 11? Ten. Is that all of them?
Yeah. Maybe it's not too bad. Maybe. So the next bit, this is where it gets confusing for me, the lubricating T-piece for the valve rocker shaft. And I can't actually see what that is. But the next bit is push rods. So they must be talking about this, taking this shaft off, I guess. So we'll whip that off now. £17 mil. Blimey. Why are those so tight? Bloody hell, fire. I'm beginning to think that wasn't a nut. Jesus. I need more lever on that. this will do it. So these must be the T pieces here, I reckon. Anyway, still got to get that out. But I think I've established that it's the nuts that have stripped, or the studs, one or the other. So the nuts are turning, but the stud is staying still. I think somebody's torqued those down, thinking they were the same as head bolts or something. So I think a nut splitter on those, which I have got somewhere, but of course I can't find it. So I'm going to buy myself a new one. Right, where was I? Nut splitter. And of course, I'm not using these, they're a bit on the crude side. Especially these cheap ones. That's getting tight.
Did that just split? Something went crack. Might have done. Just crack it from the other side. If I can. Get the push rods out. try and see if I'm strong enough to do it with this ratchet. I like to do it the baby way and number them all, and you don't have to think too much. Bigger bar. Try this one. Right, that's first go round. Second go round. One, two, three, four. They're already loose, actually. Five. Seven, eight, nine. I wonder why some are nuts and some are bolts. Got copper under there. That's never right, is it? Talking down to copper. Well, they all seem to have copper underneath. Maybe I'm wrong. Well, these two nuts are in the same position, so I assume that's correct. Nothing at all under that one. Where is the... No, nothing there. So I think we can assume this head's been off before. Well, we can because of those. No copper under that one. And copper under that. Okay. So, is it going to come off?
Easy.
So, this is the money shot. This is what you've all been waiting for. I'll take that off there, I think.